faced with the reality of a dwindling fish stock in the lake, add on to the fact that the community around Lake Victoria does not actively engage in agriculture, stakeholders are now fearing for acute food shortage in Kisumu County unless drastic measures are taken. In fact, the situation is so dire that most of the food crops sold in the county is actually imported from neighboring counties.
For example, in Kisumu, most of the vegetables and the grains come from the other region which are consumed by Asian community. And that is where I thought that this is the opportunity for the local farmers to be independent as well as turn vegetarian.
Hizi avocados zinatoka Western, maembe zinatoka upande wa Pokot huko, ndizi inatoka Uganda, hii malenge inatoka Western.
At Kibuye Market in Kisumu County, Stella Wafula is attending to her latest customer. She sells a kilo of onions at 350 shillings. The price, she says, could have been lower if she was getting her supply from the locals.
Kwa sasa kitungu tunatoa West Pokot, ambayo transportation iko very high, na pia bei yake iko juu. Na kama tungekuwa tunapanda hapa Kisumu kitungu, transportation ingekuwa cheap, na pia tungenunua in cheaper price.
Bad weather, poor soil fertility, and poverty may be the reason of low agriculture output in the region, but many believe it boils down to individual lifestyle.
Kama kuna wakati tumeenda South Nyanza, huko sehemu za ndiwa, tukatoa huko kitungu mzuri kabisa, yenye watu wa Nyanza walipanda. Sasa, hata hapa karibuni, kama wanaweza kuwa wakapanda, tunaweza tukapata mavuno mazuri kabisa, ni uvivu tu wa watu.
The net effect of this has been expensive food commodities that are quickly spiraling out of reach for most of the inhabitants of the county.
Watu wa Kisumu hawakuzi matunda kwa wingi, ndio sababu haiziwezi kupatikana. Lakini zingekuwa zinapatikana hapa, bei ingekuwa cheap.
And now, the Kenya Vegetarian Club, in partnership with the Maendeleo ya Wanawake, is encouraging women and the youth in Kisumu County to embrace agribusiness.
When we were approached by Ms. Etiano and we found that there are farmers who are ready to farm, but they don't have enough seeds and manure, that is where we thought of kind of collaborating with them. And we thought of giving the seeds of those vegetables and the grains, which are in demand, but they are not fully produced in this region.
We are encouraging each and every farmer to do her own farm so that we get ownership of the project. You do your own farm and then once you're ready with your farm, we come and give you seeds. And
the two stakeholders have been building the capacity of the locals on various aspects of agriculture to ensure more food crops is produced.
That most of those farmers needed some knowledge, because knowledge of weather, knowledge of soil, knowledge of fertilizers, knowledge of seeds, what kind of seeds we need to use, and knowledge of market.
We are telling them, please grow spinach, please grow the kind of vegetables that we can even be able to sell to our fellow friends like the Asian community, who are mostly vegetarians, because we did realize that most of the vegetables that are being sold in Kisumu come from outside Kisumu.
The two institutions also want agriculture research institutions to set base in the county to assist locals with timely information on sound agriculture.
So we have challenged the Kenya Seed Company, they are coming right from Kitale, to come and be able to train the farmers on the right kind of seeds to grow in a particular area, so that we are able to get the maximum production.
In conclusion, Vaishali is encouraging more people to embrace vegetarianism to avoid lifestyle diseases that are increasingly becoming a normal occurrence in the country and the world as a whole. Achola Simon, reporting for Channel 1 from Kisumu County.